Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I'm Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand clock and types of clock triggerings. So the discussion about flip-flops has been clearly made in our previous videos. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos, because the concepts of flip-flops has already been discussed. In the concepts of flip-flops, we have discussed about the clock. So in one of our video on SR flip-flop, so where we have discussed about SR flip-flop, we have first got an introduction to clock. There we have said that a clock is a continuous signal of which generates zeros and ones. So what we have said, and we have shown that this is what we call it as a clock. So a clock is a continuous signal which generates zeros and ones in an uniform way. So this is what we call it as 0, and this is 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So in that way, the continuous flow of zeros and ones will be generated by a clock. And whenever, and we have also discussed there, we have just discussed that whenever the clock is 1, the circuit will work. In the sense, if you want to make any changes in the circuit, the changes in the circuit is done whenever the clock is 1. So that is what we call it as triggering. So that is the point where the triggering of the circuit happens. So that is the clock triggering where the circuit will work. Which means that whenever the value of clock is 1, so there the entire circuit will change. So the value of the inputs, the value that is stored in the input will change. So based upon the value of the output will change based upon the inputs. So that point is very, very important, and we have discussed only this point at that point of time. Now we will try to understand the different types of clock triggerings. So there are two different types of clock mechanisms. One of the mechanism is level triggering mechanism, and the other one is edge triggering mechanism. So what does that mean? So level triggering mechanism means this is what we call it as level triggering mechanism. Okay, so whenever the clock is in this level, so this complete level is the place where the circuit will be, the circuit is allowed to make the changes. And whenever this happens to be true, this level happens to be false, which means whenever this level is 0, the circuit remains as it is. So the logic behind the discussion, whenever clock is 0, why it is there in the latch mode, and whenever the clock is 1, how the states will change, how the memory will change based upon the inputs, we have discussed there in the flip-flop discussion. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. So this is what we call it as level triggering mechanism. So the other type of clock mechanism is edge triggering mechanism. So what does that mean is, so this is what level triggering mechanism, and the edge triggering mechanism is this one. So this, whenever there is a transition from 0 to 1, so this edge, whenever this edge is transiting from 0 to 1, so this time the clock will be triggered. In the sense, the inputs are allowed into the circuit, and the necessary changes will happen. So whenever the edge is triggering, so whenever there is a transition from one value to another value, so in that transition the clock will get triggered. And this is, each level triggering mechanism is of two types. It is positive level triggering, and the other one is negative level triggering. Okay, and the edge triggering is of two types. This is positive edge triggering, and this is negative edge triggering. So the negative edge, this is what we call it as positive edge, because we are moving from 0 to 1. And the negative edge triggering means as and when we are moving from 1 to 0. So whenever we are trying to trigger from 1 to 0, at this edge, the clock will get triggered. So if the clocking mechanism is of this type, this is what you call it as a negative edge triggering. And if the clocking mechanism, the clocking triggering is of this type, whenever the transition is from 0 to 1 is happening. So that edge, that edge transition is happening. If the clock is triggering, means it is called positive edge triggering. Okay, so these are the different types of clocking mechanisms that are available, and these are the ways in which those clocking mechanisms can be represented. So in the circuit diagram that is provided in the exam, that circuit diagram itself states that what kind of clock triggering mechanism is used. So you should be very careful, because based upon the clock triggering mechanism, we have to find the possible outputs. So some questions may be asked on the clock triggering mechanism. So based upon the clock triggering mechanism, what kind of output is generated at a particular place? So those kind of questions may be asked. So this is the circuit diagram. This is how the clock is represented for positive level triggering, and this is how the negative level triggering clocks. So this is how the negative level triggering clock mechanism is represented, and the positive edge triggering mechanism is represented by this shape. Okay, and with a negative symbol, negation symbol used with that symbol, this is how a negative edge clock is represented, which means that this flip-flop is getting a negative edge clock triggering, which means that whenever there is a transition from 0 to 1 to 0, so on this edge, so whenever this edge is happening on the clock, then only the inputs are allowed onto the circuit. So that's very important. Okay, so this is, these are the different types of this is the basic understanding on clock, and these are the different types of clock triggering mechanisms. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding these concepts, please post your doubts in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.